Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to another video from Tall Travels. Now, I'm currently in Odessa in Ukraine. I just came from St Petersburg a few days ago. Unfortunately, I have a limited amount of time I can spend in Russia, and that time had come to an end. So I decided to come back to Ukraine, and I was looking at Kiev. So yeah, I was looking on Airbnb at the prices of old Soviet studio apartments, and we're talking about $1,200 per month. And I just thought to myself, there's no way I'm paying that. So I managed to book a place here in Arcadia in Odessa, and I've paid, I think it's less than $500 for 1 month. So that's almost three times less. So everybody, I'm just about to go into this restaurant here called Chili. I heard it's very nice food and very cheap, so let's go and have a look. So guys, I'm very satisfied. I had a big Greek salad in there, and also a really nice steak and a drink, and it cost me, I think it was 320 Ukrainian hryvnia, so that's less than 10 British pounds. Amazing. Now, Arcadia is the beach resort area of Odessa, but in winter time, or outside summertime, I should say, it's actually pretty quiet. If some of you saw one of my previous videos, I was visiting a sanatorium in Odessa, and I'm back here again. Decided to come here because it's quiet. Down there, there's a lot of traffic today because it's Friday. So guys, the more time I spend here, the more I think it's a really good idea to come to Odessa in off-season. Because as I said, you can get apartments here in autumn, winter for $300-$400 a month, which is absolutely impossible in most of the other major cities in Ukraine. Also, Arcadia is undergoing massive improvement in construction. So you've got luxury supermarkets here, shopping centers, gyms, cafes, everything you need. And I'm going to show you that a bit later. So I first started coming to Arcadia about 10 years ago, and it was a very different place then. It was very Soviet feeling, very kind of old school, and a bit of a rough kind of resort place, to be honest. So the weather's been absolutely fantastic since I arrived. Today it's 22 degrees, which is pretty amazing for late October. When I left St. Petersburg, I think it was something like 12 degrees. I think if you're a digital nomad type in Ukraine, and historically you've gone to Kiev, I think you should really consider coming to Odessa, at least for the off season. Because, yeah, the rent prices are much, much cheaper. Generally speaking, the other prices are about maybe 20%, maximum 30% lower in the restaurants and stuff like that. Now, another reason you might want to consider Odessa is the climate down here. So at this time of the year, it's warmer than cities like Kiev, Lviv, and Kharkiv, generally speaking. And also, when it comes to winter time and the rest of the country suffering at minus 20 degrees, here it's considerably warmer. So guys, since I was last here, this huge new shopping center, Gagarin Plaza, has opened. So it's pretty impressive inside. It's got a big Silpo supermarket. That's one of the best supermarkets in Ukraine. You've got Mega Sport, Citrus, an electronic store, Reserved. Everybody knows what that is, some clothing store. And many, many other things in there. Oh, and also, soon there's going to be a top gym opening somewhere in there. Next to it, we've got the Hotel Gagarin. That's new as well. Now, these days, a lot of people are wanting to move to Arcadia in Odessa because the center of the city, the historic center, is getting rather dilapidated, to be honest, and the facilities aren't nearly as good. So you can see there's a load of apartment blocks going up there and hotels. So guys, here we have what looks like another shopping center, and another big new gym is opening here, a 24-hour gym, look. Synergy Fitness Odessa. And across the other side of the road there, we got two other gyms. There's one CrossFit gym there, and there's another regular gym on the other side. And here, guys, we have a very glitzy and kitschy shopping center called Kador. And it has the best supermarket in Ukraine, Lesilpo. So let's go and have a look inside. So guys, as you can see, it's a top of the range supermarket. So if you're living in Ukraine, it's not a bad idea to base yourself close to one. So there's at least a couple here in Odessa. There's one in Kiev, in Arena City. There's one in Kharkiv in the east of the country, a small one as I remember. I think that's about it. Here we have what looks like a restaurant, a cafe, and a mosque, all in one building, which is the height of convenience. Or maybe it's not a mosque, it's just in the style of a mosque. So here's what I was talking about earlier, all these tower blocks going up. Loads of construction going on here in Odessa. Everybody wants to live by the sea. And here we have what looks like the Duke of Edinburgh. So maybe it's fake news, his death. And the real story was that he decided to pull a life insurance scam. So he came down to Odessa looking for a new wife and then got a job in a mosque. The cashless economy is kicking in here. I just had to pay for this little bottle of water with my card. They wouldn't accept cash. Oh, so I've neglected to tell you one very important detail about Odessa at the moment. I've shown you all these restaurants open, cafes open, shopping centers. Well, It's actually officially lockdown here. So nobody does a lockdown quite like the people of Odessa. Odessa's historically, with COVID, been something of a rebel city. So they don't care too much for lockdowns and restrictions and stuff like that. I mean, some of the nightclubs and bars are officially closed, but if you go in through the back entrance, everything's okay. Okay, everybody, so I'm now in Peromogi Park, which is a huge, beautiful park here in Arcadia. And it has a lake, so let's go and have a look at that. So Peromogi Park is a huge bonus if you decide to spend some time or live in Arcadia. Beautiful colours on the trees here. I have to say, autumn is absolutely my favourite season. You can come here to jog, walk your dog, cycling, messing around on the lake maybe. Got some song about Odessa in the background playing. Odessa. So some of you might be wondering why the city is called Odessa instead of Odessa as it's written. Well, the O is actually pronounced as an A much of the time in Russian, but I haven't found a hard and fast rule about where it should be pronounced as an A. To the park, Park Peromogi, and as you can see, we've got an interesting USSR monument behind me. And at first, I thought this was Lenin at a distance, but it's obviously not, because a few years ago, Ukraine went on a rapid decommunization drive, and they tore down any statue of Lenin they could find in Ukraine. So, not quite sure who this dude is, but he's there, missing his body, inside some kind of fish, it looks like. Here we go. Stefan Jevetsky, 1843 to 1938. Okay, everybody, it's goodbye from me from Peromogi Park here in Arcadia, Odessa. Stay tuned for the next video, because tonight I'm going to be going back to Antalya in Turkey. Now I'm going to be there for a week or two, and then I'm going to Belarus. Woohoo! See you later. Take care.